Steve KLENK from Galileo Digital in Los Angeles, here for the Institute. Regina asked me to join and bring a little bit of, hopefully a little bit of expertise that, I can share and help the others with respect to the digitization workflow, digitizing the film. My colleague Kushik brought a Lasergraphisc scan station personal, a 5K 35mm motion picture scanner that we're using to scan the film. And my company, Galileo Digital, is the global distributor for Lasergraphisc, the manufacturer of the scan station personal and other scanners. We also pretty much work complete workflows with our clients, scanning, restoration, color, digital storage, and data storage, LTO7, etc. It's been an amazing experience. I've been here for 4 days, and it's been a blessing to be here. I came here expecting to just impart whatever knowledge or wisdom I might have that I could help people with, and I go back having gained wisdom from the people here in Albania. I was touched by the documentary yesterday that played, and right here, it hit me here. I see now how many, many people, especially in the north, but probably the whole country, people countrywide are survivors. And there's a strength and there's a spirit that I believe is non-stoppable. Right here we've just got an example, a high definition example of a movie that we'll be restoring in 4K. But it's red dye faded material. And that means we're losing some dye in the film. And if we wait long enough and one of the colors is gone, the film is toast. It's over. If we lose all the dye, we can never get it back. Well, we did a little bit of testing here on the scanner, and what we found was this is what went through the. So we're preparing to do a restoration of a very special film done in Albania. And when we checked it out, we found that most of the film is severely red dye faded. Any dye faded film is a problem caused by a loss of dye. And as long as there's a little bit of dye, we're okay. If we lose all of any one dye, the film is over. It cannot be restored. This film is crimson red, and we put it on the scanner, and we worked with a color grading system for about 5 minutes. Actually, the person that did this is a 16-year-old whose dad is participating in the Institute, and he came over, and he was working with me, and he brought this dye-faded material to this. And the great news is we were able to get probably 90% of the color back, and such that when we digitize this movie, we can digitize it to this extent. Then we can go into a restoration and grading suite. We can restore, get rid of the dirt, the scratches, and some flicker that's in the film, as well as do some final tweaking on the color. And I think you will end up with a stunning movie. I started out my career at the University of Connecticut working in student services and teaching. I went from the University of Connecticut to PricewaterhouseCoopers Higher Education Group. Consulted with probably 220 universities, probably two-thirds of them internationally and maybe one-third in the United States. Did a lot of work on workflow, and that's where I learned a lot about archives, university archives. And since then, now that I'm working in the motion picture industry, both with studios and archives, and bring a lot of the experiences that I had in higher education. One of my loves is working with building and supporting film schools. One of the things that I like about the technology that we use, it's easy. The new technology, we've gone from lots of buttons and knobs to pretty much where everything is covered by software. Such that we can bring technology like the scanner, data storage, LTO7, the software, and within probably a couple of hours we can have students pretty proficient at scanning. Certainly within a day they can be proficient at scanning, grading, and putting together beautiful outputs of their work. It's my pleasure. Actually, it's the honor is mine. Again, I want to reiterate, the honor for me in the last 4 days was coming to learn about something I knew very little about, and that's the history and the culture and the spirit of Albania. It's been very, very special. It's been a blessing indeed.